I'm John Lawton with MachinesUsed.com. Today I'm going to show you how to find the hours page, the hour screen on a Haas with a 32-bit CNC control. That's kind of the Haas original control. From the 90s, mid-90s, through about 2006 or 2007, the Haas control would be the Haas 32-bit CNC control. Some people will tell you, oh, this has a color screen, it's a newer one. No, that's not the case. They could have the amber colored screen, they could have the green screen, they could have the screen with white lettering or color. What can give you away that it's a 32-bit control as opposed to the later cold fires or main con or next generation controls is the size of the monitor. This 11-inch monitor here, that size is the size for the older style 32-bit control. So a lot of your machines are going to have this control on it, and it would be good to know how to find the hours. Let's look at the screen, actually the buttons. We have display buttons here in the center. The buttons we're going to be using on this will be the setting graph button, the alarm button, and the position button. We will also be in the center using these cursor buttons. Left and right to toggle on things and off, left, right, and up and down we're going to use to bring us to the correct pages we need. So, the first thing I want to do is hit my setting graph button. Bang. You'll notice it has different page numbers up and down the line here. I want to go to page 7, so I go to my numbers down here. 7 is that number. I hit the number 7. And then I hit the down arrow to take me to line 7 on the cursors in the middle. Cursor down. You'll see I'm on line 7 there at the top, and it says line 7, parameter lock, on. I want to turn that off. To toggle on or off, I just use the toggle key. You'll see it's off, on, it's off there. But then to lock that in, it's in the off, I go way down to the right hand corner, the right enter screen, and hit right enter. It's no longer blinking, it says it's off. So I have turned the parameter lock off. At the end, we will turn that back on so we leave the machine in the same status as we found it. So now we go in the same display area buttons to this lower button on the left of the display called alarm messages. Hit alarm. I'm now in the alarm display. In that display, I'm going to write the word debug. That is D-E-B-U-G. I'll do it here. D-E-B-U-G. It says it right down there, debug. I got to go way down to the lower right corner and hit enter again. And when I did that, you notice there was a bunch of N's. N-n-n-n-n-n. You now know you're in the debug mode. Don't know why it says that, but that's just what it does. So now, back to this display, I said that we'd be using three buttons there. The last one is the position button. So that's right here, top row, second from the left, position. I hit it, and it pulls up the positions. Now, I want to page up to the right page. So in the same way the cursors were to go to different lines, there's a page up and page down button. So I'm going to hit page up and look at it. Not the hour screen. I'm going to hit page up again. Look at it. That's not the hour screen. Hit page up again. Well, there it is. It says system time, servo time, motion time, and spindle time. System time changes every time you turn it on, so that doesn't matter. Servo time is how long the machine's been turned on with the servos on. Motion time is when the machine's making motional moves. And then the one that everybody wants is spindle time. And this is given, in this case, in hours, minutes and seconds. So if you can see up close, spindle time on this, and you can walk in as close as you want, 12,018 spindle hours. So that would be the answer. This is the page to find that. Now, does that mean that's how many hours are for certain on this machine? No, because the things that an operator can't hit a button and change it to what he wants or anything like that. But say it sat unplugged forever and lost its batteries and memory, and they had to put the programming back into the machine. Well, they'd reload it and it would start it at zero if they did that. So that could bring it to zero. Or you might see some things where they'd replace a certain board and the hours read really low on servo on and what you would think it would be on spindle hours. So what you have to do is you have to look at the hour meter, look at the machine, look at the condition and go, yeah, that's probably right or not. But that's what you can do. When they want you to provide it, these are the hours and this is the page. I'm gonna take, do what you need to do to bring it back. For the people that own the machine, you don't wanna leave it in the debug mode and you don't wanna leave the parameter lock off. So all I'm gonna do is go back to that alarm button, press alarm messages. Still have that min here, meaning I'm in the debug mode. I'm gonna type debug again, which I typed, there it is, debug. I'm gonna hit that lower right enter button all the way down here again. Notice all the M's disappeared. It's not in debug mode anymore. Then I'm gonna go back to that display, to that setting graph button where we started, hit it. It'll pull it right back up, or right at that line 7 parameter lock. It's still toggled to off and not blinking, so I know it's in the off position. So go to the cursors and toggle. It's now in the on and blinking, which means I'm selecting on, but I haven't gone down to the bottom. Bottom right and enter. Now it's not blinking, it says parameter lock's on. I have the machine back in the state where it should be. That's how you find the hour meter on a Haas with the 32-bit CNC control and how to put it back in the shape it should be when you start it. Thank you. We showed you the screen size for a Haas with the 32-bit CNC control, and when you get to the later controls, which would be the cold fire processor control, the main con control, and the next generation control, they have a screen size like this of 15 inch. So that's the way to tell if you're not a 32-bit control. If it's got a bigger screen size like this at the 15 inch, you certainly are not in a 32-bit control. And the year that cutoff is somewhere in 2006, 2007, depending upon the model of the machine.